Controlling lights from one-way switches, two-way switches, five-way switches, one- and two-way dimmers, it's either complicated or it straight up doesn't work. And the answer to that is the REDARC TVMS Rogue. And that's exactly what we're going to cover today in lesson number 10 of this branch circuits playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the EXPLORIST Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, before we get started, there's a couple prerequisite pieces of information you need to know, like cutting wire, stripping wire, crimping terminals into wire, but we've already covered that in a specific playlist of this academy, so go back and review that if you don't already know how to do this part. And lastly, before we get started, the fuse block that we're using in this particular demo is the Blue Sea blade fuse block. Now, there's several different types of fuse blocks on the market, like the Progressive Dynamics fuse block, the Blue Sea Safety Hub, the Tiger Expedition UFO 200, and all of those are realistically going to be connected in much the same way. They're all getting their power from a different distribution hub, like the Victron Lynx distributor, which is getting its power from the battery. But we're going to skip all of that side of the system and focus mainly on how we get power to the rest of the branch circuit. Let's get started. The REDARC TVMS Rogue, or Total Vehicle Management System, is the first REDARC product that we are putting into shop.exploris.life. And in true shop.exploris.life fashion, we don't sell anything that we haven't made any tutorials about. So this is the first tutorial that is covering this device. So I'm pretty excited to show it to you because it's honestly pretty neat. And in the words of Steph, whenever I showed her the end result of this, her review was, "Hey, that's pretty cool." So let's get going. There's a lot going on right here, but it's really pretty simple when you break it down into the individual parts. You have the brain of the system here that is getting power from your DC distribution or your battery. Let's get this out of the way. Power is coming into the unit here. This next set of wires here, these orange and black ones, these are all of our circuit wires. So these are going to go out to our lights, fans, refrigerator, anything like that. That's what is powering on these. And you would just, you know, add a lever nut onto the ends of these or a butt splice connector to connect to all those. These multicolored wires right in this area here, like that. These are all just various signal wires. We're not going to be covering any of these today. They're not really applicable to what we've got going on. These blue and gray wires over here, these are switch wires where we can add switches, you know, physical touch switches to control any of these. Our screen over here be mounted to the wall, and this is also going to give us some control over the system as well. Now, without getting too much further into it, I want to talk about the end goal of what we're doing in this video. The end goal is to be able to control this light from this touch screen and the REDARC app and two different switches in two different locations connected to our switch circuits over here. So by the end of this video, we're gonna be able to turn this light on and off, as well as dim it up, dim it down from four different locations. And you'll also know how you could do it from even more locations if you needed that. So let's get into the wiring and the programming. The wiring is already finished for now. The communication wire from the back of the display screen here is connected into the display port. There's really no way to mess that up to a degree. It just goes where it fits. And then these terminators are in the unused spaces on the ends. This would be connected to power coming in. And then these are the two circuits, which is labeled as C1 from our terminals right here. That's connected positive and negative to this light right here. We're going to not worry about any of these because those are just additional circuits that you could program in the exact same way as this one. These signal wires here, we are not going to worry about these. These are for like temperature sensors, voltage sensors, that kind of stuff. Not really applicable to our needs for this video. These blue and gray wires are, now you'll notice that these are labeled as E1 through E8, and you have a, let's call it a positive and negative for each one. Now, it's not necessarily positive and negative. You're not powering anything off of any of these wires, but it's just important to know that this is 1, the next pair over is 2, the next pair over is 3, all the way up to 8. So we already have this connected here, and we should be able to, without touching anything over here, turn this on and off from the screen in the app, but we have to program the brain here to, you know, enable or disable C1. So start from the top. So we're going to be using the Red Vision Configurator app on my phone here. It's available for both Apple and Android, but we're going to be configuring everything here, telling the brain what to do here, but also sort of in conjunction with the display screen over here. So I'm going to be jumping back and forth a little bit between the three, but I'll do my best to sort of point to what is being actively programmed. So we're going to go over in our menus and click on the Bluetooth function there to make sure that all of this is ready to communicate via Bluetooth. From there, go into my app and read device. From there, I'm going to click on the connect button here to connect my app to my display screen and therefore to the TVMS Rogue. Now that the Red Vision Configurator has read the information that is already programmed onto the TVMS Rogue, we can go ahead and start doing our programming here. So we're going to click into Wiring Configuration, TVMS Rogue, and then we can go into our outputs here. So remember that our light is connected to C1, so we're going to tap into output C1. I'm going to name it, give it an icon, Which one looks like lights? Hey, these are lights. And then we're going to scroll down and tap user control and ensure that enable light dimming mode is toggled to on, and then click save. We'll tap back and then we'll go to switch inputs. Now for this, we're going to be programming our switch inputs, which if you remember is E1 through E8 right over here. And so I'm going to tap into switch input E1. We're going to call it light switch 1. Give it an icon. And then I am going to tell it that I want it to be a push button, normally open switch. We'll explain that more in just a second. But there's all kinds of different options that you can use here. Save. And we'll do the exact same thing for switch input E2. Now we have our two switch wires over here configured. We can back out again. And then we can open up control configuration. Tap into light switch 1. We can choose output or group, and we can tell it that we want it to control our lights circuit right here under C1. We're going to set the control logic to dimmer, which is on off toggle, press and hold. This will make more sense in a second. And then we're going to do the exact same thing with light switch number 2. And with our two light switches programmed, these two over here, we're going to back out. And then we're going to go into the TVMS display, which is this. We are going to go into soft keys here, and we are going to set the first soft key, which is this little guy right up here, to our lights. Same thing, dimmer, on, off, toggle, press and hold. Save. And then we're going to click on home screen. And you only have to do this once for all of these, but the default display doesn't show what these are. And there's all kinds of different options. It sort of kind of doesn't matter which one you pick, but as default, the lights or these circuits are not on there. So you can just sort of pick whichever one has these lights on the sides, which is literally all of the other ones. All these can be as none because those are temperature and tank levels. Save. And that's good to go. Back. Back again. And then we're going to press program. And we're choosing to program it to this brain right here. And so the app is now going to connect to the brain and the screen, and it's going to send everything that we just did. It's going to push it to this brain and the screen so it can be displayed and properly programmed. And this takes, you know, 30 seconds or so. The screen just rebooted and is back to where it was, and we got a success message here on the app, so asking to go back to the dashboard. We'll click continue there. We'll back out of this right here and see if our main screen is set up. And now you can see a new icon popped up here on the left side. So when we tap it, that light turns on and off, just as we expected. Now, if we wanted to control this light from the app on our phone, there's actually a secondary app. This app is just the part that lets you configure what you're seeing and what the circuits are. But we can go back out and go to the REDARC RedVision app. Then I can tap up into the menu for the device. And I noticed that my soft keys aren't showing here. We should have this same logo here. And so we're just going to tap up here and then go into settings and then full scan. And it's going to reread the system and try to resynchronize everything. And my soft keys actually showed up, but they're under controls. They're not under home here. They weren't there just a minute ago. I promise I looked. But now we can turn the light on and off from our phone, or we can turn the lights on from our phone and off from the display screen, or we can dim them on by pressing and holding. Grace, can you hit the lights on that side? And the lights are all the way up, and we could press and hold it on the display screen to dim them down, dim them back up from the phone side. It's kind of a slow dim, but it's kind of nice. That flashing you're seeing, that's just on the camera. That's not actually being in real life kind of thing. Or turn them off, turn them on. So we have our two-way switching and two-way dimming right here on the control panel, as well as on the app. But what if we wanted some kind of like physical switch here to turn them off and on from a switch mounted in the wall? And we can totally do that. This is just a momentary on-on switch, which means that when you press the button on the front of this, it simply connects this terminal and this terminal. There's nothing fancy going on here. It's simply connecting, disconnecting, connecting, disconnecting, and that's it. So when we connect the gray and blue wire from E1 together, the light goes off if we just tap it. Tap it, it turns back on. If you tap and hold, not tap and hold, if you just hold them together, it's going to dim off, disconnect, reconnect and hold. It's going to dim back on, tap on to turn off, we turn it on from here, we turn it off from here. Same thing with E2, it's just another switch. It's going to work the exact same way because that's what we programmed it to do. Connect, on, off, dimming. And you know, this isn't how you would actually control it, you know, in real life. So I'm going to go ahead and add these two switches to these circuits. So now we have switches on both of these E1 and E2 switch signal circuits. So we can press to turn them off, press to turn it on, press and hold to dim, press and hold the other one to undim. Oh, nope, it just keeps dimming. Press and hold again, and then it's going to dim back up. Turn it off, turn it on, off, on. Like, I think you can see how this works. I think that's pretty clear. And this is really the only way to do this. You can't do four-way dimming from just normal. dimmer switches like we showed in a previous lesson. It just doesn't work like that. So go check out that video if you don't believe me, because I sort of demoed it. So this is really cool. We really like how this works. This is something that people have been asking for like a year, how to accomplish multi-position dimming in a system like this. And I think it's really cool too that on the display screen, whenever you turn one of these on or off, you know, it lights up right there on the display screen, on both the display screen as well as the app. So I hope that this was helpful. This is the reason why we have added the REDARC TVMS Rogue to the EXPLORIST.life store, because it just gives you ultimate flexibility in all of the circuitry in your camper van, RV, boat, tiny house, whatever you've got going on, and we really think it's a great addition. Another thing I did want to add, that if you wanted a second display screen, if you're feeling bougie and you wanted a second display screen, you can simply get another communication cable and another display screen, and that would just connect here, and you'd go to another display screen, and then this little guy would just go in that other display screen, and then it's gonna have the exact same functionality. You can have as many display screens as your budget allows for. So I do hope that this series of playlists featuring branch circuits of various capacities was helpful, and that actually wraps up our branch circuit playlist of this Mobile Marine and Off-Grid Academy. And in the next playlist, we're going to take a deep dive into batteries, BMSs, battery types, and battery communications. So click up here to get started on that. We'll see you over there.